Thomas Edison State College was awarded a federal grant to conduct an economic analysis of a region that comprises 19 urban municipalities in northern and central New Jersey. U.S. Senator Frank Lautenberg joined college officials and local leaders in Irvington on October 20th to formally announce the grant.
Today marks a new beginning for economic opportunity in urban centers, urban communities across New Jersey. This $240,000 federal grant is seed money to help grow more jobs and sprout stronger urban economies.
We're here today to announce what we think is an exciting opportunity to partner both with the Urban Mayors Association, with cities in the north and north central section or region of New Jersey, and with the Urban Mayors Association to really identify what the economic assets are and to find ways to streamline resources to build economic development across the state of New Jersey and specifically for the purposes of this grant within the north central region.
This federal program is the first step in rebuilding New Jersey's economy, putting people back to work, making our state stronger and more prosperous.
These resources, again, are going to play a critical role in helping us think through what we need to do to have a long-term economic plan that would allow New Jersey and our urban centers to really flourish.
This grant will bring together 19 cities and 7 counties, along with the private sector, to establish strategies for economic growth. This grant also opens the door for future investment in the region.
The university, through its wherewithal, through its diligence, and its understanding of our rules and regulations, i.e. cutting through the bureaucratic red tape, recognized there was an opportunity to assist not just one community, not just one entity. They're able to effectuate change and opportunity for at least 19 deserving communities.
We know the planning tools that this grant will allow us to do will be the economic engine that we need to bring real businesses like Manufacturers Reserve. We've expanded here in the township of Irvington over the last few years. At the end of the day, it's real jobs and real businesses that make the difference in neighborhoods. So we're delighted to be a part of this process. We will work, as we have assiduously done with Thomas Edison, in framing some public policy solutions to advance New Jersey cities.
The college also touted its John S. Watson School of Public Service and Continuing Studies, which recently launched new areas of studies at the graduate level designed for professionals who work in the public service.
The John S. Watson School of Public Service was created 2 years ago in an attempt to provide support to the public service sector professionals that really are the undergirding foundation of the state of New Jersey. This sector, if you will, provides all of the opportunities we need to make sure that we have the quality of life that we need.
Even though the job market has shrunken, the fact is we still need to educate people. Because we've got to expand the job market. B, we've got to have the people trained to do it. And this is a program that says, okay, study what you got, learn, think about what you have to do to cure the situation, and help bring life into the urban centers. It's crowded with people who can learn, and we've seen it time and time again. If someone has a chance to learn, you can never, never underestimate the outcome.
Irvington Mayor Wayne Smith said Thomas Edison State College and its Watson School is uniquely positioned to help develop the next generation of public service leaders.
If we're going to prepare New Jersey's future leaders, the Watson Institute is at the cutting edge of providing the kinds, whether it's in the environment, whether it's working with local elected officials like urban mayors, whether it's developing public administration programs that prepare people to run departments. Thomas Edison is really on the ground, not only in theory, but working with people who are solving problems every day. So I think that gives them the advantage that probably no institution of higher learning in the state has. They're actually in the trenches, taking the theory with the practice.